morning.
And welcome to worship on this first day of August as we celebrate Camp Mount Luther Sunday here at United in Christ. My name is Chad Hirschberger. I serve as the director at Camp Mount Luther, and I have brought some staff with me. And during the sermon time this morning, we are going to share with you some of the things that we have been teaching our campers this summer. This, starting today, is our very last week of the 2021 camping season. So we're going to be wrapping up the ministry that we've been doing all summer long. And as part of that, I wanted to thank you here at this congregation, because if you didn't know, you've been sharing your pastor with us all summer. Pastor Justin has been our chaplain to the staff and has been engaging in faith formation activities with our young adults, including the ones that are with me today. And we have just really enjoyed having Justin with us and tapping into his knowledge and having him mentor our staff in their faith walk. And I'm going to tell you, it's a little bit tricky to be supplying for Justin, because I just don't know if I'm as animated as he is. But how's this? Does that work? All right. I've spent enough time with him this summer. So. Terry has some announcements. She's also the video person. Hello, everybody on Facebook.
If we're not passing the... currently not passing the fellowship pads, so if you could please fill out an attendance card, and then you can place it in the any of the offering plates. We're actually not, we won't have communion today, so you don't have to check that. And go ahead, if you want to talk about social ministry.
Awesome. Don't forget, we're collecting school supplies.
Any other announcements we should share with one another? All right. Marilyn is doing music today, and I told her that I recognized her from the videos, because I watched some of your videos during the pandemic, and now she's like a piano rock star. So please prepare your hearts and minds for worship during the prelude.
Thank you.
stand as you are able. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the God of manna, the God of miracles, and the God of mercy.
Amen.
Drawn to Christ and seeking God's abundance, let us confess our sin. God, our provider, help us.
It is hard to believe there is enough to share. We question your ways when they differ from the ways of the world in which we live. We turn to our own understanding rather than trusting in you. We take offense to your teachings and your ways. Turn us again to you. Where else can we turn? Share with us the words of eternal life and feed us for the life of the world. Amen.
Beloved people of God, in Jesus, the manna from heaven, you are fed and nourished. By Jesus, the worker of miracles, there is always more than enough. Through Jesus, the bread of life, you are shown God's mercy. You are forgiven and loved into abundant life. Amen. Our opening hymn is number 733 in the ELW, Great is Thy Faithfulness.
Thank you.
Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness.
Come into God's presence with singing.
Know this, the Lord is God. Know this, we belong to the Lord who made us.
Know this, we are God's people and the sheep of God's pasture.
So enter God's gates with thanksgiving. Come into the holy courts with praise.
Give thanks to God and bless God's holy name.
For the Lord is good. God's steadfast love endures forever.
God's faithfulness is for all generations.
Let us pray. Almighty God, your faithfulness has endured from generation to generation, and your goodness comes to us new every day. By the work of your Spirit, lead us to acknowledge your goodness. Give thanks for your benefits and serve you in willing obedience. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
You may be seated. So, today what we're going to do is we're going to read for you the five Bible stories that we've been talking about at camp under our theme, From Generation to Generation. We just actually recited our theme verse in a little responsive reading that we did. It comes from Psalm 100, verse 5, and it says, "For the Lord is good. His steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness for all generations." And we've been talking about how God gave a promise way back when, and in my best Justin impersonation, he gave the promise, capital T, capital P, the promise. And it was given to Abraham and Sarah that they would have lots of descendants, and we'll hear that story in a minute. And that promise that God gave has been passed down from generation to generation. And if we read stories in the Bible, we see where these people lived out that promise that God had made. Throughout all kinds of things happening in the world, and they kept true to God, and God was true to them. And it goes all the way down through stories in the Old Testament, which you're going to hear in a minute, to the big promise of Jesus who came through Mary, which is one of our stories we'll hear. And then how after Jesus, Jesus' apostles went out and spread this love that God has, this promise that God has given to other people through people like Timothy and Paul and Lydia. And God's promise and God's love spread and continues to the very final part of the promise for now, which is us. We are part of this long line of God's promise and love from generation to generation. And we have to spread that so that it continues to the next, everybody?
Generation.
Very good. So let's hear these stories. Before we do that, though, I'll have the staff introduce themselves and tell you their name and where they're from and what they're doing at camp this summer.
My name is Annie. I'm from Belleville, Pennsylvania, and I am the parent communicator at camp this summer.
My name is Grace. I'm from Turbeville, Pennsylvania, and I'm a counselor this summer.
Hi, my name is Maddie. I'm from Mickleton, New Jersey, and I'm the craft director this summer.
Hi, my name is Daisy. I am from Cogan Station, Pennsylvania, which is right next to Williamsport, and I am a counselor this summer.
All right, so as Chad said, we are going to start with God's promises to Abram and Sarah. God came to Abram and made a promise. "Abram, you are very special to me. I will take care of you and give you lots of children and grandchildren and great-great-grandchildren." But Abram asked God many times, "Are you sure? I don't have any children yet." God thought Abram needed something more to help him understand. So God took Abram outside and showed him the night sky. Your family will include as many people as there are stars in the sky, God told Abram. Abram stared up at all those stars. He couldn't begin to count all those twinkling lights. Stars and stars and stars all around him. Abram looked up at the stars and saw God at work. Abram believed God. Now for another promise, said God to Abram. You will need a place for your huge family to live. I will give you this land as I promised. Are you sure, God? Abram asked again. God made a covenant with Abram, a promise that Abram would become a father and a grandfather and a great-grandfather and a great-great-great-grandfather, and on. And all of Abram's many, many, many sons and daughters and grandsons and great-granddaughters and on would live in God's kingdom in the land on which Abram stood. So we start off with the Abraham and Sarah, and that's the beginning of this promise that we're talking about throughout the whole week. And what we try to get across to the campers is that God is with us through the journeys of life. So this is a big journey from Abraham and Sarah. They have to go travel on a long distance to get to this land, and they had to trust in God's promise that they would have these children and these descendants. So yeah, this is kind of just the overall beginning of the promise and how it relates to us. We learn about that on all the other days, but it's kind of just the start, and we talk about how God is with us through all of our journeys, and even if we don't understand maybe what's going on, we have to trust in God's promises. So our second story that we learn is the story of Joseph. Joseph helps his family. God always watched over Joseph. God spoke to Joseph in dreams, and Joseph used this knowledge to plan ahead. When the famine came, people from all over came to find food for their families because they heard that Joseph had saved up for 7 years. Even Joseph's brothers traveled to Egypt to find food. But it had been such a long time since they'd seen each other, the brothers didn't recognize Joseph. Joseph kept the secret of who he was from his brothers for a while, but soon he couldn't wait any longer. Joseph finally told them who he was. I am your brother, Joseph, whom you sold to the Egyptian traders. Don't feel bad anymore, because God sent me ahead of you so that I could save people, including you. This famine is going to last for many years, so hurry back to our father and tell him that I am safe. I want you to bring your families and your children and all of your sheep and goats to live near me. Once Joseph's brothers saw who he was, they all hugged each other and cried. They jumped up and down with relief and joy. Joseph and his brothers talked and talked. The brothers talked from the time the sun came up to the time the sun went down. When the Pharaoh heard that Joseph's brothers had come, he told Joseph, "Tell them to go get everyone in your family. I will give them the best land in Egypt to call their own." Joseph gave his brothers wagons, food, and new clothes, and they went back to their father and told him the good news. Joseph is still alive. He's the ruler of Egypt. Everyone danced when they heard the news. This is all I could ask for, Joseph's father said. Now I will see my son again. Let's get moving. Joseph's family all moved to Egypt, but the brothers were worried. What if Joseph is still angry with us? We were so awful to him. What can we do? The brothers went to Joseph and said, "Here we are. We don't deserve to be your brothers anymore, so we will be your slaves." But Joseph said to them, "Don't be silly. I'm your brother no matter what. Even though you planned for something bad to happen to me, God turned it into something good." So with this story, we want to show that God's promise is with us even through like rough times. Joseph went through a lot of rough times before he got to where he was. And that's especially prevalent like today with everything going on in the world. God is still with us even though there's bad things going on. And we find it important to share that God doesn't cause bad things to happen in the world, but when they do, he's with us and he can turn them into good.
For day three, we talk about the story of David chosen to be anointed. God said to Samuel, I have a job for you. I want you to anoint a new king. Here's what you need to do. Bring a horn filled with oil to Bethlehem and look for Jesse and all of his sons. One of his sons will be the next king. Samuel was afraid that God's job was too scary. The old king was still around and he was a very mean guy. But God promised Samuel, I'll help you. So Samuel walked to Bethlehem and found Jesse. Line up all of your sons and let's see who will be the next king, Samuel said to Jesse. Samuel looked at the first son, Eliab, and felt sure God would choose him to be king. Eliab was big and good-looking, but God disagreed. Samuel was looking at the outside of Eliab, seeing how strong he looked. God was looking at the inside and did not see the right love in his heart. One by one, the sons came forward to see if they would be chosen. This one? Nope, sorry. This one? Oh, no. What about this one? I don't think so. Finally, they ran out of sons, except for one, that is. Jesse's son David was outside watching the sheep. They called for him. David came inside. He smelled a little bit like sheep, but his eyes sparkled with joy and love. David was just a boy, gentle and quiet. Samuel tried to see David from outside and inside. This one? A hush fell over the room as everyone waited. Yes. God told Samuel, yes, Samuel told everyone. Samuel poured oil from the horn onto David's head, anointing him with God's love and joy. David would be the next king.
So for this story at camp, we try and focus on David being chosen for the love in his heart. And since we have a lot of younger campers, we try to talk about how David was pretty young when he was chosen to be king and how God chose him. And God chooses us to go out and do things for his kingdom, just like he chose David. So we try to get across the point that they can be chosen too, even though they might be pretty young, and that God looks on the inside and not on the outside.
And then for day four, we see the connection between the Old Testament and the New Testament with the promise. Because in day four, we talk about how the promise came to Mary. Mary was a beautiful young woman. She lived in a town called Nazareth and was engaged to be married to a man named Joseph. One day, a tall and handsome man appeared in front of Mary. His clothes were brilliant white. His hair was dark and curly, and his eyes sparkled like lights. Mary knew the man must be an angel. "Hello, Mary," he said. "God is with you." Mary stepped backwards. His deep voice scared her. "Don't be afraid," he said. "God sent me to tell you that you are going to have a son whom you will name Jesus. He's going to be very important to many people." "A son? But I am not married yet," she said. "How is this going to happen?" "The Holy Spirit will come to you," the angel replied. "Your son will be the Son of God." "The Son of God? My son?" Mary thought all about these things. It didn't seem possible, but she believed anything was possible for God. "I am God's servant. I will do whatever God said," she said, but her mind was racing. What will Joseph think? Would he believe her? Mary was nervous. When Mary told Joseph about the angel and about giving birth to God's son, he did just what she was afraid he would do. He didn't believe her. He talked about not marrying her anymore. Mary felt so sad, but she remembered what the angel said and she trusted God. The next day, something wonderful happened. Joseph came to her and said, "An angel came to me in a dream," he said. "Joseph, don't be afraid to make Mary your wife. She's going to have a son and you're going to name him Jesus. He's going to save people from their sins." Mary smiled a big smile. She was so happy that tears of joy filled her eyes and trickled down her cheeks. She felt Joseph's love again. "I am not scared for you to be my wife, Mary," he said. "I will be with you, and we will name the boy Jesus." On day four, we have to have fun with it and sing some Christmas songs and celebrate in that way. But what we want to highlight for the kids in the story of Mary is that she was given a really surprising and maybe daunting job, a lot of responsibility, but she trusted in God and she praised him. She was so excited about it. It was a little scary. And one day, I remember an especially memorable way that we had the campers maybe experience this same responsibility and surprise is we told them, okay, for 5 minutes, campers, now you're in charge, and the counselors are going to be campers. And the counselors ran around, and the campers were like, wait, what's happening? And so that was kind of a way that we showed the campers, this was something really surprising, but we are trusting you with something important. God was trusting Mary with something really important, that capital T, capital P promise in the form of a baby.
So our last story is Paul, Timothy, and Lydia, but we've been focusing more on the story of Lydia and her call to ministry. So Paul traveled to many places teaching people about Jesus. One night, God told Paul, go to another country and teach people there. Paul listened to God. He got onto a big boat. Up and down, over the waves, the boat went, sailing to a faraway country. When he got there, Paul taught. Jesus loves you, he said. Jesus came to earth to teach us how to live and has saved us all from our sins. An amazing woman named Lydia heard Paul teaching. Unlike many other women of that time, Lydia had her own business. She sold beautiful, expensive purple cloth to rich and famous people. Lydia said to Paul, tell me more about Jesus. I want to learn everything I can about the Son of God. Paul told her about Jesus' teachings. Love everyone, he said. Share with others, he continued. And most importantly, he finished, remember that God loves you forever. Lydia was amazed. I want to be one of Jesus' followers, she exclaimed. Will you baptize me and everyone who lives in my house? Lydia, Paul, and all of the people who lived in Lydia's house went to the water. They splashed into the cool wetness. Paul baptized each of them. I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Lydia said, thank you. Will you stay at my house with my family? Paul said, sure, and went to stay with Lydia. Lydia became a follower of Jesus. She was very generous, using her money to help many people. Jesus loves you, she told as many people as she could. Jesus has saved you from your sins. Follow Jesus. He is the Son of God. Many people learned from Lydia, the amazing woman who sold purple cloth. So for this day, we focus on Lydia and how willing she was to go out and serve after she was baptized, and how she had that want and readiness to be baptized, and how through Jesus we should want to go and serve as well. And we talk a lot about how kids can share the love of God like Lydia did with others around them, and the ways that they can take all the things they learned that week of camp about sharing God's love out into their everyday lives, and how they can bring the capital T, capital P promise into their daily lives as they leave camp.
So I hope you have seen how we have shared with our campers this summer this idea that God has given us this promise, this love, these blessings that are new every morning, and that it has been passed down from generation to generation. It was passed to Abraham and Sarah first, and then it was passed through the generations down to Joseph. And Joseph showed forgiveness because of that promise to his brothers. And then it got passed down more, and it came to King David. And King David shared that promise through his reign as king. And then, of course, Jesus is of the lineage and a descendant of David. So that was passed down all the way through Mary and to Jesus, who kind of exploded the promise more. Shared that and a new way of life with lots of people. And those people got excited about it and went out and shared it. And that got passed down through the people in the New Testament and onward and onward and onward and onward and onward until it comes to us. And so we then have the responsibility and the privilege of sharing that with others. One of the ways that we help campers to take these messages and these stories that they learn home is to sing lots of songs with them. It seems to be the best way that kids will take a piece of camp with them home. I know this because I have parents who have told me over the years that they love hearing the camp songs and hearing about these things that the kids have learned throughout the week until they've sung the same song 47,000 times. Then they're like, okay, enough's enough. So we thought it'd be fun to share with you one of the songs that we sing with the kids in the summer. And I am going to ask our chief guitarist, who didn't bring his guitar, but Michael has joined us. You should come up, Michael. While Michael's coming up, Maddie has said all summer long that from looking at Michael and I from the backside, that he could be my son. And now he's worn the same shirt, you see. So, you know, it was not planned. By the way, speaking of sons, this is my son, Aaron, who is one of our campers. Do you want to help sing this song with us? Come on. Would you like to teach our song?
Yeah. So, everybody repeat after me.
Repeat after me.
Our God is an awesome God.
Our God is an awesome God.
He reigns from heaven above. With wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. All right, you can stop repeating after me. And if you saw us doing the motions, if you feel so inclined, you can try to do them yourself. But we'll just sing through the whole thing once now.
But you won't get the whole experience of the song.
That's
if they
true.
Don't.
Emotions are really nice. All right, so let's go.
Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God.
Let's do it again.
Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above.
More opportunities if you would like to be part of our summer program this year. This week we have Pick an Adventure Camp, so if you or people that you know want to come, this is a program for any age, adults, kids, young people. It's a day camp from 9 to 3:30 Monday through Friday, and you can come to camp and you get to kind of pick and choose what you want to do. And pick your own adventure, and our staff will help lead folks through that. So, for instance, if you want to try out canoeing and you've never canoed, you could come and say, I want a canoe, and we'll say, okay, and we'll take you canoeing. So that's this week. That's our last program of the summer on site. But also this week, we're doing our virtual CML program, which we started last year as part of the pandemic. And so throughout the week, we're going to be doing some Facebook Live events. The first one is tonight at 6:30. We have a live campfire and worship service that'll be live streamed on our Camp Mount Luther Facebook page, which is facebook.com/Mount Luther, spelled out. And so that's tonight. Then each morning this week at 9:15, we're going to do our First Light morning devotions live streamed on the Facebook page. And so if you want to hear more about these stories, we'll be going through these stories again, singing some camp songs. It'll probably be about 15, 20 minutes long, starting at 9:15 each morning this week. And then Thursday night, also at 6:30, we're going to do a closing campfire for the summer, again, live streamed on our Facebook page. So it's 6:30 tonight and Thursday night for campfire, and our First Light devotions each morning this week, starting tomorrow at 9:15. So if you want to check out some more of what we've been doing this summer, feel free to join us for those, or you can come to Pick an Adventure. It's very laid back, the Pick an Adventure. If you're like, wake up in the morning and you're like, I think I'm going to go do it, just come on up. You don't have to let us know. And we're providing lunch too, so yeah. So thank you. Thank you for having us today and allowing us to share with you some of the things that we've been doing this summer. And I would be remiss if I did not also thank you as a congregation for all your support over the years for Camp Mount Luther, not only supporting us with your prayers, but also donations over the years. And this summer, you adopted one of our staff members, Lucas King, who was supposed to be with us this morning. Unfortunately, Lucas is not feeling well, so he thought it'd be best not to come today. But You've adopted him and have shared with him some notes of encouragement and some gift bags with goodies and so forth throughout the summer. It's a program that we've done the last couple years where congregations and individuals help to kind of boost morale and show that our camp staff are part of a larger thing than just being at camp, but are part of the connections that we have with congregations in the Synod and the extension of your ministry as well. So we thank you for doing that this summer with Lucas and for being our partners in ministry. So now, as the staff goes to sit down and you stand up, we will get ready to do our greet together. Let us confess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Rooted in Christ and sustained by the Spirit, we offer our prayers for the church, the world, and for all creation. You have revealed your love for people overlooked and cast aside, sending your Son to be born among the humble and poor. Send your church to proclaim good news to those who feel abandoned, despised, or rejected, and make our congregations places of genuine welcome and hospitality. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
All creation longs for healing and restoration. Thwart the destruction of plant and animal habitats and amplify the voices of those who advocate for wise stewardship of the earth's resources. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We remember your promise to our ancestors and look to you for justice. Expose pride, greed, and exploitation wherever it is found, and raise up humble leaders who act on behalf of those who are poor, oppressed, or in other need. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Your Spirit lives in our hearts and makes us heirs of salvation. Rescue us from shame and dishonor. Lift up the lowly, fill the hungry with good things, and have mercy on those who turn to you for help. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Mary's song of praise and amazement echoes throughout this assembly. Attend to those in this congregation expecting a child, and console those struggling to conceive. Come to the aid of those enduring a difficult pregnancy and those who have experienced a miscarriage. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We give thanks for the saints who have found refuge in you, O God, especially Abraham and Sarah, Joseph, David, Mary, the mother of Jesus, Paul, Timothy, and Lydia, as you have delivered them from all their afflictions to save us from all our earthly troubles. Do that for us too until the day when we sing your praise together in heaven. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We lift these and all of our prayers to you, O God, confident in the promise of your saving love through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
We remind you that during the pandemic, there are opportunities for you to support the ministry and the work of this congregation and the work of the wider church through the offering plates that are throughout the sanctuary, or because you are so technologically savvy, you could do it online. And your bulletin, I think, has a QR code, and you can use your smartphone to do that. Now, if you're like me, you might not be so smart to know how to use the smartphone to do that, but if you need help, you can ask my 8-year-old son. He will show you how you can. But we thank you for sustaining the ministry and the work of the church through your tithes and offerings. Let's now give thanksgiving for the word of God. Let us pray. Praise and thanks to you, holy God, for by your word you made all things. You spoke light into darkness. You called forth beauty from chaos, and you brought life into being. For your word of life, O God,
we give you thanks and praise.
By your word, you called your people Israel to tell of your wonderful gifts, freedom from captivity, water on the desert journey, a pathway home from exile, and wisdom for life with you. For your word of life, O Lord,
we give you thanks and praise.
Through Jesus, your word made flesh, you speak to us and call us to witness. Forgiveness through the cross, life to those entombed by death, the way of your self-giving love. For your word of life, O God,
we give you thanks and praise.
Send your spirit of truth, O God, rekindle your gifts within us. Renew our faith, increase our hope, and deepen our love for the sake of a world in need. Faithful to your word, O God, draw near to all who call on you. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory forever.
Amen.
Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us, saying,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Receive the benediction. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Amen.
Our sending hymn is number 576 in the ELW. We are all one in Yeshua.
Okay, we will.